In this video, we will show you what acne is and how to deal with it so that you have a skin you are proud of. What causes acne? You may have heard it said that no one really knows what causes acne. While causes of acne may be individualized to an extent, some actual causes can be identified. It depends a bit on the type of acne you experience, your age, and your lifestyle. Here are some of the possible causes and triggers of acne. Causes. Causes are different from triggers. For example, clogged pores may cause acne, but something triggers the pores to get clogged, or triggers them to become inflamed. Some possible causes of acne may include the following. A high glycemic diet. Studies show a connection between high insulin levels in the body and the development of acne. Eating foods that convert quickly to sugar in the body, that is, high glycemic foods, causes the body to produce large amounts of insulin to keep blood sugar levels stable. This large amount of insulin in the blood may cause or worsen acne. Some health professionals have been known to call acne diabetes of the skin. Hormonal shifts. When you hit puberty, wean a baby, begin menopause or premenopause, take birth control pills, etc., you experience hormonal shifts. Hormonal shifts are actually a common, normal, and relatively frequent occurrence during the average lifetime. After menopause and into old age, hormones tend to become more stable and not as subject to fluctuations. But that can take a while. In the meantime, hormonal changes may cause various types of acne, such as rosacea or localized breakouts. Hormones may be responsible for increased production of oil or sebum on the skin, which is one of the contributions to clogged pores. Stress. While it's somewhat controversial, some conjecture that stress plays a role in acne. This may be due to the stress hormones that are produced when you suffer chronic stress. These hormones, particularly norepinephrine and epinephrine, are male hormones and are implicated in the development of acne. Also, during stressful periods or chronic stress, the immune system may be less effective. This could make the skin more vulnerable to bacterial infections and therefore acne. Various types of acne and how to manage them. A pimple is a pimple, right? Not necessarily. Acne actually takes various forms, and how you treat it can be different depending on what kind you have. Here is some information on the basic types of acne and how to treat them. Whiteheads or comedos. These are perhaps the least noticeable of the acne types. They are small, white bumps under the skin without redness or pain. They are closed, meaning the material clogging the pore is trapped beneath the skin's surface. It's tempting to squeeze or pick at these, but experts warn that this can introduce unnecessary irritation and open the skin to infection. Here are some tips for treating whiteheads. Leave them alone. Don't pick at or squeeze them. Wash your skin twice a day with a cleanser containing benzoyl peroxide. Moisturize your skin, even if it's oily, with a hypoallergenic moisturizer. Consider one containing jojoba oil, it's said to help regulate the body's natural oil production. Blackheads. Blackheads are slightly open, allowing some of the clog to be excreted from the pore. It's this open nature that accounts for the black color. This happens when your skin cells oxidize in the presence of air. Treating blackheads involves the same as above, except it's a good idea to remove the clog with the following suggestions. Gentle exfoliation may help remove blackheads. Masks or exfoliants that contain salicylic acid tend to be especially effective. Papules. Papules do not have a head, but they are red and swollen. Do not squeeze a papule, say experts, that can cause swelling, irritation, and scarring. Attempts to squeeze could force the infection deeper into the skin. Treat papules the way you would whiteheads, but be very gentle and do not rub or scrub or exfoliate the skin. Pustules. When you think of a pimple, this is usually what comes to mind, A red bump with a white head that is just begging to be squeezed. If you must squeeze a pustule, medical professionals advise gently poking the white head with a sterilized needle and draining the pus with tissue-covered fingers. Besides, or instead of, squeezing pustules, you can also follow the tips for treating whiteheads above. Cysts and nodules. This type of acne should never be squeezed either, say health professionals. Cysts are painful, red and swollen. In addition to gentle cleansing and skin care, some other tips for treating cysts may include applying cortisone cream to reduce swelling, seeing your dermatologist for a cortisone shot or other steroid treatment. When it's not acne, some skin conditions can mimic acne, such as rosacea, various types, skin allergies, eczema. There are also more severe, unusual types of acne that do not necessarily respond to conventional acne treatment. If you are uncertain as to whether or not you have typical acne or something different, your dermatologist should be able to diagnose the condition and prescribe appropriate treatment. Triggers. Triggers may be more individualized than causes. A trigger might be an allergy or sensitivity that is unique to certain sensitive individuals. Other triggers are more common. Here are some better known acne triggers. Food allergies. For allergic individuals, eating problem foods creates inflammation, and inflammation plays a key role in acne development. Hair products. Hair products are often overlooked as a possible skin irritant, but acne triggered by hair products is more common than most people realize. Acne triggered by styling gels, conditioners, etc. tends to occur along the hairline or the jaw and neck. Telephones. The bacteria buildup that may occur on telephone receivers can infect skin with acne-causing bacteria. A telltale sign is acne along the jaw, chin, and ear, occurring on the side you use most when you hold the phone to your ear. Can acne be cured? For those who suffer from acne, the number one question that may be bothering you is, can it be cured? Because acne varies from individual to individual, the answer is generally yes, depending on the treatment approach and type of acne. Here are some of the possible cures for acne, from natural home remedies to more medical approaches. Probiotics. Some proponents of natural health, particularly those who practice traditional Chinese medicine, believe that the skin reflects the state of the digestive organs. According to this view, acne is evidence that the body is trying to rid itself of toxins that have accumulated due to poor digestion and elimination. For this reason, probiotics are sometimes suggested as a form of acne cure for those who take a more natural approach to health. Probiotics are said to improve digestive health, which is then reflected in the skin. Diet. Some interesting evidence has come to light that connects diet and acne. Most notable is the possible role that insulin plays in skin health. Studies show that high levels of insulin correlate with the presence of acne. Diets high in sugar and refined grains tend to increase the body's insulin levels, sometimes causing spikes in blood sugar followed by crashes. Thus, a diet that does not cause increased insulin, such as one that includes whole grains, lean protein, and little sugar, could help cure acne. Nutrition. Some health experts point to vitamin and mineral deficiencies as causing or worsening acne. Vitamins A, B complex vitamins, especially B6, E, and C are vitamins that are said to be especially important for skin health. Chromium and zinc are considered important minerals. So making sure you get these important nutrients via supplements or foods might prove to be a beneficial step toward curing your acne. Homemade cleansers. Some people have success treating their acne with homemade cleansers. Here are a couple of ideas. Mix 1/4 cup of Greek-style plain yogurt, or strained plain yogurt, with 1 teaspoon of apple cider vinegar or lemon juice. Gently massage into skin and rinse with lukewarm water. Crush an aspirin tablet and add it to 1/4 cup plain Greek yogurt along with 1 teaspoon honey. Use as a cleanser twice a day or as an occasional mask. OTC cleansers and treatments. There are some cleansers and topical treatments available over-the-counter, OTC, that may help cure acne. Experts recommend cleansers containing benzoyl peroxide. Antibiotics. Sometimes, your dermatologist may feel that antibiotics are warranted to treat your acne. For some people, a course of antibiotics does act as a cure, because once the infection has cleared up, the skin can recover. Steroids. For very inflammatory acne, such as cystic acne or nodules, doctors may prescribe steroids. These are either injected or applied topically. Steroids reduce inflammation and help stop the cycle of acne formation. We are sure you have learned enough about acne to deal with it. When you apply all the things learned in this video and have the result you desire, we expect you to come back and drop a comment for us. It's Psychic Fix.